Hello guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Essa, and in today's video, I'll be sharing with you my experience with the CCNA. I just passed this exam. What I will do for you in this video is that I will be answering the most asked questions. It's a questions that I was hoping myself to find an answers for. The questions that I will be covering in this video will be including, what is the CCNA? Is it worth it? How much would the exam cost? How many exams in there? What's the questions format? How to pass the exam in 6 weeks? How difficult was the exam? What is the required score to pass that exam? What is the exam duration? Most of these questions and even more will be covered in this video. Stay tuned. All right, so let's start this video by answering the first question. What is CCNA? CCNA stands for Cisco Certified Network Associate. It's provided by Cisco. Obtaining this certificate will prove that you have the core knowledge and the hands-on experience to work as a network administrator. What is the CCNA prerequisites? Similar to many other certificates out there, there are no prerequisites to take the exam. However, Cisco recommends that you have 1 or more years of experience implementing and working with Cisco solutions. They also recommend that you have a basic knowledge of IP addressing, as well as you have a good understanding of network fundamentals. Please, 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 don't let that discourage you. There are many people out there, including me, went for that exam without any previous experience in networking and passed that exam from the first time. I'll definitely explain to you how to do that after answering the main questions first. So how many CCNA exams out there? There is only one exam that you need to take, which is CCNA 200-301. This is the only exam that you need to take. If you pass this exam, you will get your CCNA certificate. How much does the CCNA exam cost? The exam will cost you only $300. So how long is the exam and how many questions are there? I'll be answering these questions according to Cisco, as well as my experience when I took the exam. The exam duration is 120 minutes, 2 hours. And you would expect to get from 100 to 120 questions. Me personally, I had 104 questions. I know that can be frightening at first sight because you will have around 1 minute per question. Honestly, I thought myself that I will run out of time before I even complete my exam. However, after I started my exam and I saw the questions, I realized that there was many questions that will take you less than a minute. Honestly, I completed my exam and I had 45 minutes left. So don't let that scare you. There is another thing that you have to be aware of. Cisco exam is not like Security Plus and all the other exams out there. You can't go back to the questions. If you remember in my previous video, my trick was that I would skip the questions that I don't know and I would go back to it later after I answer all the questions that I know. But in Cisco exam, you can't. Whenever you pass that question, you can't get back to it again. But also, it is doable. If I did it myself and many others in there, trust me, you can do it. So don't stress out. What is the questions format? Most of the questions that you will get will be a multiple choice questions and drag and drop questions. Many questions from what I got was basically running a command. They will run a command for you. For example, let's say show IP route, and they will ask you a question about that and they will give you the options. Sometimes it's going to be a single answer. Sometimes it's going to be multiple answers. I'll also include for you a tutorial from Cisco website. It's a 2 short videos that it's 2 minutes each. It's just going to show you how the questions on the exam looks like. I honestly recommend you to go and see it just to know what are you getting into. And don't worry about the other type of questions that you will see there. It's not going to be in your exam. That's mostly for another type of exams. It's not for the CCNA. So you will have the multiple choice. You will have the drag and drop. You won't have fill in blank and any other question. What is the passing score? Cisco will give each a different passing score. However, this score will be from 800 to 850. It's not gonna be higher than 850 and it's not gonna be lower than 800. And the way Cisco grades you, they will start you with 300 points right away before you even start your exam. And then you will be building from there. Another thing to mention, how would you know what the needed score for you to pass? Before you even start your exam, they will give you some instructions. It will tell you what is your passing score. Me personally, I needed 85% to pass my exam. I will also say it one more time. Don't let the passing score stress you out or scare you away. I honestly did not know what's the difference between a switch and a hub 6 weeks before the exam. And I passed the exam with a high score. So don't let this stress you out, please. You got this. I believe in you. Believe in yourself. Okay, does the CCNA certificate expires? Yes, unfortunately, it does expire. You need to renew it every 3 years. Now, to the important question, is the CCNA worth it? My answer would be yes. This certificate is definitely worth it. Why? For many reasons. First, network is everywhere. Therefore, having a basic foundation of networking is a fundamental to a successful career in information technology and any other field. The second reason would be that this certificate will prove to your employer that you have what it takes when it comes to networking. You have the skills, you have the knowledge to troubleshoot and to work as a network engineer. All right, so now let's talk about the money. How much would you expect when you get your CCNA certificate? And this is one of the things that tells you that, yes, this certificate is worth it. It's only one certificate, but it's gonna open many doors for you. According to Glassdoor, the average CCNA salary in the United States is $72,381. You can also look up your country. All you need to do is just write CCNA, and after that, choose your country, and it will tell you what's the average salary for CCNA in your country. How difficult is the CCNA exam? I'll be answering this question the exact same way I answered how difficult was Security Plus. You are the only one who can answer this question. You are the only one who decides how difficult this exam could be. If you prepare the right way, I promise you this exam won't be difficult at all. Don't let anyone discourage you. As I mentioned in my previous video, there are many people out there. The first thing they will tell you is that this exam is so difficult and there is no way that you're gonna get that certificate. Why? Not for anything. Sometimes they don't really mean to discourage you, but they wanna feel accomplished by telling everyone how difficult it was and how challenging it was, and they finally made it. Don't let that stress you out. I believe that everything is possible in life. It's just how many work you are willing to put into it. And as I mentioned before, everyone is different. I'll talk to you about my experience. Me personally, when I start asking everyone about the CCNA, because I came from a different background with no networking experience, I was told that this exam will take me 3 months of preparation. I was told that there was a high chance of me failing the first exam. I was also told that I need to read the two books, volume 1 and volume 2, if I wanted to pass that exam. And guess what happened? I passed the exam in 6 weeks. I did not read both books. Why? Because I'm a visual learner and I found my own way of passing the exam. I would refer to the books when there is materials that I couldn't find out. So I use it as a reference, but I did not read the whole book. So this is for you guys who are visual learner like me and are wondering if it's a must to read both books. No, it's not, and you can definitely pass it. And on top of that, I passed with my first try and there was 45 minutes left and I got a good score. How to register for the CCNA exam? All you need to do is to go to Pearson and you're gonna create an account. Then after that, you will look up CCNA 200-301. When you find the exam, you're gonna add it to your card. You're gonna buy the voucher for the exam, which is $300. And after that, you can schedule your exam. Me personally, I scheduled my exam in the same day when I felt that I am ready. What resources you need to pass your CCNA? Before I start giving you the resources, I wanted to mention that I'm a firm believer that education should be free for everyone. And you will realize on my previous videos, on this video, and on my upcoming videos, that I will always try to include a free resources that you can use. If for whatever reason I could not find a really good resource and you have to pay money, I will make sure that I will get you the least expensive and the most effective resources out there. For the resources, you need to buy the CCNA 200-301 Official Cert Guide Volume 1 and Volume 2. You can find them on Amazon. The Kindle version will cost you around $20. If you want to go for the hardcover, that's more expensive. You would pay around $37 for Volume 1 and you would pay around $34 for Volume 2. If you want to prepare the exact same way I prepared, I do not think that these two books is enough. I needed more resources, especially that I'm a visual learner, so you will find me all over the place looking for good materials, good videos to learn from. And I would definitely refer to these books only when I search for something specific that I can't find out there, or if I wanted to see a different explanation other than videos. So I would definitely get more other resources. There is also another source that I believe it will help you out. So instead of you go, for example, to Udemy and buy a course from there and buy these two books, and after that you will end up paying a lot of money. So what I suggest you to do, there is a website called O'Reilly. I don't know if you are familiar with that website. By the way, this video is not sponsored by them. I just found it a really helpful way to study for this certificate and for many other certificates. O'Reilly, they have a 10-day free trial right now, so you can go sign up there and look for the books. You will find both books. You can also have access to many other great books in there. And after the free trial, that will cost you $49 a month. I believe this is worth it, because if you count it, that's going to be equivalent to only two books that you're going to purchase now, and you're not going to use them after the certificate. You're just going to put them in your shelf and refer to them whenever needed. But when you have this access, you have more resources to study from. Even for the CCNA, there is great resources. I will definitely put many links for you on the description, so you can go and check it out, and I'm sure it's going to help you with your exam. One of the great resources on O'Reilly that I found, and I really liked it so much, especially that I'm a visual learner, it's called CCNA 200 301 by Kevin Wallace. I was recommended this course by my friend, and I really liked it so much. It helped me a lot. I love the videos. I love the way he organized it. It's just straight to the point, and he would really help you to understand what you need for the CCNA. And as I mentioned before, I would include this resource, and I will also include every resource gonna help you on the description. Now let's go to the last resource that you need to pass this exam. Similar to Security Plus, similar to many other certificates out there, you need to be familiar with the wording of the questions. Why? Because it doesn't matter how many knowledge you have on the field, they can trick you with some questions. There are many questions that you think you know the answer for, but the way they word the question is gonna throw you off. So I honestly recommend you guys to go and look for practice questions for the CCNA. If you just Google it, there are many practice questions out there for the CCNA. You can just write CCNA 200 301 practice questions and look how many questions you're gonna find. So if you wanted to step up your game a little bit and you wanna have high quality practice questions, you can go for the resource which known as Boson. Boson practice exam is really good. The thing I loved about it is that they will give you the question, and after that they will show you the answer and why this is the correct answer. So you will have an explanation for every question and every answer. That's a great thing. However, it's a little bit pricey. It's $99. If you want to go with that resource, with all means, go for it. It's a great resource. If you feel that you can afford it, just Google. There is many great practice questions, because what you need is just to see the wording of the questions and to assess yourself and answer these questions and see how knowledgeable you are with their material. So if you want to pass your certificate within 6 weeks, the exact same way that I did, I just shared my resources with you. I would also encourage you to do your own research. Look for things that works for you personally. I also have to say that you have to be committed. If you really want to make it within 6 weeks or 5 weeks or even 4 weeks, you have to be committed. You have to study. Give yourself a minimum of 3 hours every day. Not only that, network should be everything in your life. When you are in your car, you have to be listening for some networking podcasts. When you are at home, instead of watching movies, play any YouTube videos about networking on your TV. When you are eating, having your phone around, just play any other video about networking. So you have to really go to the level where when you sleep, you would be dreaming about networking and you will be troubleshooting in your dreams. So you have to be committed. You honestly can do it, guys. Don't let anyone discourage you or talk you out of it. You got this, I promise you. If I got it myself, you guys definitely can do that. Everyone can do it. So don't let anyone discourage you, please. To help you out, guys, what I would do for you is that in my upcoming videos, I'll do my best to do some CCNA videos. It will be mostly with labs. I'll be using the GNSS3 because this is what I used when I was practicing for the exam. Doing the labs will actually help you to see why this answer is correct instead of just reading the answer. So I love the hands-on, I love the practice, and I will do my best to help you out in my upcoming videos. I'll be doing lab that specifically target the CCNA. I will try to make the videos straightforward. If you guys have any other questions that I forgot to cover in this video, please feel free to write it down in the comments and I would definitely answer your questions. I hope that this video helped you and encouraged you to go for your CCNA. And as I always say, don't let anyone discourage you. Don't let anyone make you feel that it's difficult and you can't do it. If I did it myself, and if the person who's trying to discourage you, he did it himself, trust me, you can definitely do it. I believe in you. You have to believe in yourself. And I can't wait to read the great news in the comments. So I'll be waiting for you guys. Tell me whenever you pass your exam. If you are scheduling your exam soon, please say it in the comment. We all support you. We are all rooting for you. You got this. I believe in you. Believe in yourself. And see you in my upcoming videos. Thank you, everyone.